What up, players? It's WarbossTae up in his mud. Welcome to my final video for the How to Paint a Death Corps of Krieg Commissar. And here's the finished product. This is also my July project, July Painting Challenge Appreciation video for Patrick Gaumond. So let's get started. First, we use Mephiston Red, Wazdakka Red, Gehenna's Gold. This is Mechanicus Standard Gray, Moot Green. I think that's it. All right, so here we go. This is just also the finished version. If you want to really get into the details and the highlighting, because I don't think we got into any highlighting with the last video. Mephiston Red first. So if you'll remember, we ended with the Agrax Earthshade Brown. And now that that's nice and dry, we're going to go back over with Mephiston Red and highlight up the base coat of corn red. And again, we're gonna hit the fringe, the sash here, the commissar's red sash, and the red trim on the greatcoat. I'm having so much fun, you guys, with the new iMovie app, if you haven't noticed from all the trailers I've been throwing up on my channel. So nice smooth lines. You want to thin down your Mephiston Red on your wet palette, and you'll see that it's a hard angle to reach because he's unsheathing that power sword. So you're going to have to turn the model in your hand and get the right angle so that your brush doesn't knock into any of the other parts of the model, and that's why I use this little piece of cork there. So I always try to find the best angle to use my brush, because brush control is a huge part of brush control is finding the right angle where you can brace your hand and be able to hit the model with the right color at the right angle. So you know, everybody's different, and for me, sometimes hitting these vertical lines, like you saw the trim on the lapel, I kind of went at it from an upside down angle by holding the brush upside down while bracing my palm. But here, while I'm hitting the fringe of his shoulder epaulette, I'm just bracing the palm of my hand against my left hand, and I'm only really hitting the edges of the fringe. I'm not starting with the bright highlight color at the very top. What this does is it allows the Agrax Earthshade still in the shade, in the recesses, rather, at the top of the fringe that connects it to the greatcoat to still be nice and dark. And it makes the fringe itself look like it's flaring out. Again, trying to hit that lapel and the collar. Now I'm going for the trim of the hat. Commissar's hat, very important. One of the most recognizable pieces of equipment in the Astra Militarum Imperial Guard, of course, is the black Commissar hat. Don't want to see that coming. Means trouble. So now that that's done, I'm going to go and I think the next highlight is a Wazdakka Red. So I was actually debating whether or not to do the second highlight, and there are so many great colors out there that you could use instead of Wazdakka Red. For example, it was really a toss-up between Wazdakka Red for me and, oh, what was the other one? Wild Rider Red, which is more of an orangey red. Wazdakka is really just, it's very red, and it doesn't have any orange undertones to it. So if I wanted the red to pop even more, I probably would go with it transitioning into more of an orangey yellowish color with Wild Rider Red. Wild Rider Red is really, it shouldn't really be called red. It's more of an orangey color, but being able to use it on top of Mephiston Red and just very, very lightly use it. That's the trick with the second highlight. You don't want it to overpower the highlights you did before. So Wild Rider Red would have been a perfectly acceptable substitute for Wazdakka Red. I think I just felt like his, the Commissar's trim and everything, I wanted it to look very very, very severe and red, and not to go into that transition into orange. I'm sorry, some of these shots are really hard to see because of the angle of that hand taking out the sword there. Alright, now we're gonna go with Gehenna's gold. And something that I realize now that I'm thinking about this tutorial that I forgot to film was the highlighting of the gold eagle on his hat. I think I only got the pommel of this sword here. So if I could go back, I would also hit the gold of his commissar's cap so that it matches. Because when you look at the model straight on like that, the gold of the hat and the pommel of the sword, if you're looking at the model straight on, just like that, is what's going to really pop out at you. Okay, Mechanicus Standard Gray is our black highlight. Now this is a toss-up for me because I could have also gone with a dark blue, like Incubi Darkness. That's also an acceptable way to highlight black. In fact, that's how I would highlight most high-quality cloth or power armor. I decided though when looking at this model that I was going to go with the gray instead. Because with the army that I'm painting this guy up for, this commission Death Corps of Krieg army, he needs to look gritty and in the trenches. And when you highlight with gray, highlight black with gray, it gives that more gritty feeling to it. I could have even gone with a second highlight of a gray color, lighter gray color, but maybe with a little bit of brown mixed in. So that would be your Skaven Blight Dinge, your Storm Vermin Fur. That would be a fine second highlight. You could also do Dawnstone. As it is though, when I looked at this model after doing this Mechanicus Standard Gray highlight, I think I was able to catch most of the reflective points. The great thing about Abaddon Black and the old Chaos Black is that when you paint it on, it's so glossy that if you shine a light directly on it, for example, the painting light of my table is kind of positioned at the... I've got a couple of lights shining on my model right now, but the most prominent one is coming at it from, I would say, the bottom left hand of the screen. And when the model gets hit with that light, the Abaddon Black really shines in certain... when you hold it in a certain direction. So what I'm trying to do with my Mechanicus Standard Gray is just catch those highlights so that if you pick up the model, it'll simulate a light source shining from the, you know, that bottom left hand side of the screen. Traditionally, where you want your light source to be coming from actually though is when you're looking at a model and you're holding it. I've always learned from some great local painters that you want the light source to be coming in from the upper left-hand side. Like the light is shining down, like there's a light in the room, or the sunlight is hitting the model from the upper left. But I think the way my lighting setup is, I still kind of get that effect because I've got two other lights going at the same time in order to catch the model while I'm filming it. Alright, so there is that. Can't believe how much this figure has changed since the original paint job that it had. I'm really happy with it. Moot Green is next. And what we're doing with this is we're just adding a little flash of color onto the metal on his chest. And this is the one closer to the lapel, you might remember. And that's it. Alright, thanks for watching, everybody. Don't forget to check out Patrick Gaumond's channel. And we'll see you in the next video.